On September 23rd, a tragedy struck the nation of Taiwan. A large portion of the town of Guangfu was wiped out by a catastrophic flood which carried away homes and affected hundreds of structures. Currently, 14 people are confirmed dead and at least 24 are still missing, with many scenes of absolute devastation. What had occurred was the result of a geologic disaster, specifically a landslide combining with a meteorological disaster, specifically heavy rains from a passing typhoon. And this geologic aspect is why I am covering this tragedy in today's video, despite a heavy meteorology component. While this tragedy happened 4 days ago, we can actually trace this disaster to 2 months ago, when what appeared to be an interesting seismic event was cataloged by the US Geological Survey. It was apparent that the seismic event, which registered as a magnitude 4.9, was no ordinary earthquake. Instead, this was the result of Taiwan's largest landslide of the 21st century. But you might be wondering, why did this get picked up by seismometers? Well, anything that releases seismic energy can be detected by seismometers, and seismic waves are not only released by earthquakes. Any vibration or rapid movement of the ground can also generate them, including but not limited to landslides, volcanic eruptions, explosive usage at mining operations, and even meteorite impacts. In the case of the landslide I'm referring to, it occurred at 5:53 p.m. local time on July 21st, 2025, in a highly mountainous region 15 kilometers west of the town of Guangfu. Just looking at the mountain in question, we can see dozens of small landslide scarps that comprise its edifice, and in fact, one such medium-sized landslide occurred here sometime during the first 3 months of 2025, which I have outlined. One reason for the frequency of landslides here is that while many of the surrounding similarly rugged mountains are composed of schist, this particular area is composed of marble. While marble is essentially the metamorphosed rock that results from heating and pressure but not melting of limestone, this does not change its composition, which retains an important flaw. Notably, both are composed of calcium carbonate, which easily erodes when exposed to anything acidic. And rainfall, which is all too common in Taiwan, just so happens to be slightly acidic. I suspect that the earlier failure removed marble that had been holding up the slope above it, causing stream to build until it finally gave way on July 21st. Then, all at once, a crack that had formed on the mountainside gave way, causing a more than 2 kilometer-wide stretch of the mountainside to collapse to the south, with debris moving at high speeds up to 5.6 kilometers away. While this sizable landslide did not directly harm anyone, it caused another problem. As part of the landslide debris, which was up to 122 meters or 400 feet thick in some spots, ran into and thus blocked a local river, damming it. As a result, this river fed an ever-growing landslide lake. As this lake level rose, its water quite likely started to slowly permeate through the dam, as is typical in landslide dams. This expanded over the following 2 months, growing to contain a lake that may have been up to 200 meters deep in one spot and contain 80 million cubic meters of water. Yet, there was a danger from the approaching typhoon Ragasa. It dumped more than 20 centimeters of rain in a short time span on the affected region, causing the water level to rise and eroding the landslide dam further. Eventually, the water from one side of the landslide dam reached the other side on September 23rd, causing it to begin spilling out. Once stirred as a trickle soon turned into water gushing out until a large chunk of the landslide dam was removed, giving direct access for the high water in the landslide dam to rush down a canyon to the east. It then spread out upon reaching a wider segment of the Guangfu River, overtopping its riverbanks and causing the observed damage. This isn't the first time, nor will it be the last instance of a landslide dam outburst flood in Taiwan. Other similar instances have occurred in different locations in 1951, 1979, and 2009. Stay tuned for more updates. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.